This is Card Sharks, pilot number 2, VTR 31778, take one.
Thank you. Welcome to Card Sharks, a game of decisions where you can win a fortune on the turn of a single card. Now let's get to the cards. Hello there, Janice, and great to see you. Ladies, if you will, start loading in the cards. And we'll play the upper cards, the red cards, by the champion. The lower cards, the blue cards, will be played by the challenger. And as the ladies finish loading up, we'll meet today's Card Sharks. Judith, nice to see you again. This is Judith Garwood, our returning champion. Won over $4,000 yesterday.
Yes.
Judith, tell us a little more about yourself.
Well, I'm single. I'm a stockbroker with a New York Stock Exchange firm, and I beat the sun up in the morning.
Yeah?
I do.
How come?
Well, because I have to be at work very early. I make that market opening.
That's right, with the time difference.
That's right.
How's the market doing?
Well, it's had a little bit of a rally.
Never mind.
After the show.
Oh, I see. You're going to sell stuff. We're meeting our challenger for the first time. This is Mr. Johnny Smith. Hello, Johnny. Welcome
here again.
Good to see you here.
Thank you.
Want to tell us a little about yourself, sir?
Well, I'm an unmarried father of four, one boy, one girl. Two St. Bernards.
Two St. Bernards?
Oh, yeah.
Big ones, yeah.
And I work an X-ray technician at Martin Luther King Hospital.
Good. Well, nice to have you here with us. Good luck in the match for both of you. Let's take a look at the cards. We play our game with two decks of 52 playing cards. The cards on top, the red cards, will be played by Judith, our champion. And the lower cards, the blue cards, will be played by the challenger, Johnny. The object of the game is to work your way across the board, predicting whether each of these cards is higher or lower than the one that precedes it. Now, before you can call high-low on the cards, you have to first win a high-low toss-up question. All of our toss-up questions are based on a poll of 100 people, so you'll have a chance to test your ability to judge human nature. And the first question, which goes to you, Judith, we polled 100 married women. We asked those 100 married women in a California studio audience, if you discovered your husband had been unfaithful, would you divorce him or forgive him? How many said they would divorce him?
I don't think many would get a divorce over that. I'd say 27.
You say 27?
Yeah.
Yeah. We didn't add the third category, how many would kill him. So, Johnny, do you think the actual number is higher or lower than 27?
They discovered so much. I'm going to think it's lower.
You say it's lower.
Yeah.
All right, let's find out. If it is lower, Johnny, you get first crack at the cards. If it is not lower, then Judith goes to the board first. The actual number of married women who said they would divorce their husband if he had been unfaithful is 23. It is lower. That's a surprise. Johnny, you get first crack of the cards. We'll take a look at your base card. You won that high-low toss-up, so you have the right to change this card if you'd like. And you have an 8.
Oh.
You want to play that or you want to change
no,
it?
No, lousy card. Let's change it, please.
All right, here's your next card off the top of your deck, and you must play this one. Let's see if it's a better one. It is a 4. That's a better card. Johnny, is this next card higher or lower than that 4?
Higher than the 4, please.
Say higher than the 4, and the audience agrees with you. Higher than a 4, it is a king. Very much higher. Yes, very. Johnny, at this point, you can freeze and protect your position, or you can continue calling high-low all the way across the board. But if you make one missed call on any of these cards, you lose all of the cards back to your original base card, and Judith would get a crack at her cards. What's it going to be? Are you going to freeze or continue?
No, we'll play on and lower than the king.
You say lower than the king, and remember, if it's another king, you lose. It must be lower. It is a 4. Wow.
Hey.
Out and back and forth. It's a 4. Freeze or continue to play?
No, we'll play off. In fact, out for the 4, another king. Higher than the 4, please.
Higher than a 4, and it is a 2. And you lose all three of these cards back to your base card. And Judith, you got to look at your base card. You cannot change it. It is a 7. You must play it.
Oh,
call this card.
Higher.
Say higher than a 7. It is a 10. That's higher. Judith, same options apply. You can freeze or you can continue.
No, I'll try one more lower.
Lower than a 10, and it is an 8. Just a little bit lower. You going to continue now or are you
going
to freeze it?
Oh, I'm going to freeze now, Jim.
You'll freeze it. So we'll move the freeze bar over. The 8 becomes your new base card. We can't take that away from you. You need just 2 cards to win. Janice, if you will, fill in the spaces here, and we'll get to the next high-low toss-up question. Before we do that, I must tell you that the first player to get to the end of the board wins the game and $100, and we play the best 2 out of 3. The winner of the match gets a crack at the money cards and possibly as much as $28,000, over $28,000. Johnny. We go to you with this question. We asked 100 senior citizens in Southern California, have you ever tried marijuana? How many said yes? Senior citizens.
Yeah, about 60 of them tried it. Yeah, about 60.
You say 60. A little acting job. All right. Judith, he says that 60 senior citizens have tried marijuana. You think it's higher or lower?
Oh, no, not even Southern California is that stoned. I'll go lower.
You'll say lower. The actual number of senior citizens who said they've tried marijuana is 16. Much, much lower. Yeah. All right. Judith, now you can change that 8 if you like. You didn't
it
before?
Yes, I'll change that 8.
Then here's your next base card, and it is a king. Good card to play with. Call this card.
I'll call it lower.
You say lower than a king. It is an 6. That's an interesting card. You can try to turn this last one over and win the game, or you can freeze it.
Jim, I'm going to freeze again.
You're going to freeze it?
I'm freezing, yes.
Moving it up, playing a little conservative, but that's all right. Johnny needs 4 cards. She needs just 1. She's got her own decision to make as we go to the next high-low toss-up, this time to you, Judith. We asked 100 college girls on the Berkeley campus, do you find yourself thinking about sex at least once a day? How many said yes?
It's got to be a lot.
See, I told you we were going to test human nature.
Oh, yeah. I think a lot of them do. I'll say 83.
83.
Yes.
Judith, I'm not going to ask you why you said 83. I'm going to go over to Johnny. She says that 83 find themselves thinking about sex at least once a day. Higher or lower?
Gee, that's so close.
That's so close.
Yeah. A little lower.
You said lower.
Just a little.
Okay. The actual number of college girls who said they think about sex at least once a day is 81. Just a little lower.
A little bit lower.
Just what you said, John. Johnny, you can play this 4 now or you can change it.
We'll play the 4 again. Higher, please.
Higher than the 4. We have another 4. Oh! Johnny, the cards aren't working your way. It's a big break for Judith. You must play off this 6. Judith, if you can call this card correctly, you have the first game in the match. What's your call?
I'll call it higher.
You say higher than a 6. For the win, it is a 3. It's not higher. Cards jumping around. Fill them in, Janice. We'll go to the next question. And this is the 4th and final question. It's sudden death. Someone has to win with this next play of the card. So control of that board is most important. This question decides it. Johnny, to you. We asked 100 dentists, are you nervous when you go to another dentist to have your teeth fixed? How many said yes?
I think everyone's nervous. 70.
70. Higher or lower, Judith?
Oh, no, I don't think dentists are that nervous. Lower.
You say lower.
Lower.
Having sat in a dentist chair, I hope it's higher. That's nothing against your call. All right, here we go. The actual number of dentists who said they're nervous when they go to another dentist is 68. It's lower just by 2. Judith, you have control, and it is sudden death, and here's how we play it. We have a very interesting situation. Judith, you can change this base card if you'd like. You don't know what that next card is going to be. If you turn this one card over correctly, you win the game. However, you've got control. You can force Johnny to play off this 4. He cannot change it. He would have to turn over all 4 cards correctly, or the game is yours. It's your decision. Do you want to play it yourself, or do you want to force Johnny to play it?
I don't think he can do it. I'm passing.
Putting the pressure on Johnny. Johnny, you've got to turn them all over. You've got to start with this 4. One mistake, and the game belongs to Judith. Call this card.
Up high. Once more, up high.
Higher than a 4. It is a 5. You're still in the game.
Up high.
Higher than a 5. It is a 7. Getting a little tough. Higher again. One mistake. It belongs to Judith.
Big
this has
now.
To be
Big
higher
one.
To stay in it. It is a jack. One more card. Can he do it? Call it. Lower.
Lower.
Lower than a jack. The game is yours if it's lower. If not, the game belongs to Judith. It is a three. Four cards in a one. You've done it. Wow. $100 in the first game of the match. We play the best two out of three. We'll be back with game number two right after this. Deal it out, Dennis.